So, this is the last session that how to publish your application on a Google Play Store. So, in this session, I will tell you how to what is the publish process and how to get ready for a successful product launch. So, before you publish your application on a Google Play Store and distribute it to the users, you need to get your application ready and test it. So, the preparation and publishing tasks are numbered so that it will give you the rough idea. So, the first step is what? Understand the publishing process. So, before you begin your application, before you begin the steps in the checklist, you should take a moment to read and understand the overall publishing workflow and become familiar with the process work. Second, test for app quality. So, before you publish your application on a Google Play Store, it's important to make sure that it meets your basic quality for all the Android applications. Third one, determine the country distribution. Google Play lets you control a different territories for your application, and therefore, we can determine the country distribution. Fourth one, confirm the application overall size. So, the overall size of your application can affect its design and how you publish it on a Google Play. So, currently the maximum size for your application, that is for an APK on a Google Play, is 50 MB. If your application exceeds that size, or if you want to offer a secondary download, you can use that APK expansion files. Fifth one is what? Confirm the application's platform and screen compatibility ranges. So, before publishing, it's important to make sure that your application is designed to run properly on the all Android platform version and device screen sizes. So, you need to determine what platform your application are going to run. Sixth one, decide whether your application will be free or priced. So, there are two types of application which will be either free or priced. So, on a Google Play, you can publish your application as a free or price. So, free application can be downloaded by any Android users, but the paid application can be downloaded by only users who have registered form of payment, such as a credit card. Seventh, prepare your promotional graphics. So, when you publish on a Google Play, you can supply a variety of high quality graphic assets such as image, icons to showcase your application or a brand. So, after you publish, this will appear on your product details page or in a store listing wherever you will search your application. Eighth one, build and upload the release ready APK. So, when you are satisfied that your application meets the user interface or compatibility or quality requirement, you can build the release ready version of your application. Second last, final checks and publishing. When you think that you are ready to publish, then take a few moments for a final checks, such as do you have the right version of the application uploaded, or do you have set your application pricing free or priced. And the last one is support the users after launch. So, after you publish your application, it's crucial for you to support your customer, which can provide a better experience for the users, such as better ratings or any feedback or any kind of problem that may have regarding the applications and such as. Now, these are the four phases of the publishing of an application, and we will see one by one. So, first one is the aiming at the right device. So first thing you need to consider the Android version. So let me go to the Eclipse. So this is your Eclipse IDE. And in the left pane, I have project name Android app. So let me open the XML file. So this is my layout. So this is a simple layout which has Aakash wallpaper, and I will tell you the settings of how to adjust the screen sizes, what are the different form factors, and how to package your APK and all. So first thing you need to consider is the Android version. So for that, right click on the project, go to the properties, and in the left pane you can see the Android category, and there you have a different Android version. So Aakash tablet uses the Android 4.0.3. So I am selecting Android 4.0.3 version, which has API level 15. Click on OK. So second thing to consider is the minimum API level. So double click for that, double click on Android manifest file. So in the left pane, I have Android manifest file. Then go to the manifest tab. And in the uses SDK, select the uses SDK. And there I have minimum SDK version that is already been set to 8. Then I have a target SDK version that is 14 and the maximum SDK version. So what are these three versions? That means my application will definitely run on API level 8, that is Android 2.2. Now the one more thing to look at the feature set. So for that, so what is the feature set? So suppose your application relies on some features such as a camera, Bluetooth. So you have to clarify this in the manifest file. So click on add, select the uses features, click on OK, and here you have a name field in which you have to name your feature set. So suppose this application relies on camera, so I will write Android dot hardware dot camera, and I need to set the required field to true. So that means after you publish this application, this application will only be visible to the devices that has a camera facility. Since I don't need these features, I will simply remove by selecting the hardware, the Android dot hardware dot camera in the manifest extra, and I will click on remove. Yes. So if you want to learn more about this topic, just go to the developer site. In the developer, click on developers, go to the API guides. So, in the left pane, you can find, you will find a Android manifest. Click on it, then go down, and here you have a uses feature category. Select it, go down, where is it, uses features. So, these are the different uses features. So, these are the hardware features that have, Bluetooth, camera. You can also incorporate the software features. So, these are the software features such as a live wallpaper or SIP and all. So, now we will move to the second phase of publishing an application. So, the second phase is form factor and screen sizes. Now, this topic will give you a few hints of how to best prepare your application for a different screen sizes on or a form factors. So, if you look at your application in a graphical layout and on a different screen configuration by selecting one of the devices from this list, then you will, then it will look quite different on a different screen sizes. So, let me take the 7.0 WSVGA screen, and now you can see that actual information of this application on such a big screen looks very small. We can also change the Android version from here, that is from 4.0.3 to Android 2.3.3 or 2.2. So, when I select the API level 8, that is Android 2.2, and now you can see my content is looking some older kind of. So, for that, to handle this, we have two possible solutions. First, restrict your application either to specific Android version. So, for that, click on manifest. So, here I have manifest. Select the manifest tab, select the uses SDK, and here I have already set the minimum SDK version to 8. So, what is the minimum SDK version? That means your application will definitely run on Android 2.2, and the target SDK version is the version on which your application has developed. And now I will set the maximum SDK version to 15. So, that means my application will definitely run between the Android 2.2 and Android 4.0.3, that means between API level 8 and 15. After selecting this, my application will not run on a higher version, that is 17 or 16, that is Jelly Bean. You could also add support screen features. So, what is the support screen feature? So, for that, click on add, select the support screen features, click on OK, and there you can see I have small screen, normal screen, large screen. So, if you want to support the small screen, set it to true. Normal screen, if you want, set it to true. But if you do not want to set your application on an X large screen, set it to false. Since I do not need this restriction, I will simply remove this. Now, the second thing you can do is providing a different layout. So, what is the different layout? So, for example, you may want to provide some additional content for a larger screen or for a larger sizes. You simply create a new Android XML. So, for that, click on wizard, give the name of XML, so main, click on finish, sorry, click on next, and here you can see the available qualifier and the chosen qualifier. So, now I will select the size element, and if I want to move this size element into the chosen qualifier box, I just need to press this button and set the size to the X large and click on finish. And now you can see I have created a new XML file for a larger screen. So, this is about the form factor and screen sizes. Now, we will move to the third phase, that is packaging a release build. So, in this topic, we will make our application as a production ready. So, for that, we firstly need to have project, that is I already have the project here, that is Android app. So, if you take a look at your application folder, so let me switch to the Eclipse. So, firstly I need to find the location of this project where I have stored this project. So, for that right click on Android app, go to the properties. In the resource category, you can find the location of this project. So, I have to go to this folder. See document setting eStudio desktop Android app. So, this is my Android app. Where is it? Yeah, this is my Android app. And if you open this, you can see there are some other folders, and inside the bin folder, you have some generic classes. So, we do not need to touch them except the Android app.apk. So, your APK resides in the bin folder. So, what is the APK? So, APK, it's an application bundle ready for the installation on an Android device like Aakash tablet. And this is the file which creates as soon as we hit the run in Eclipse. So, here I have run button. So, as soon as I click the run button, it gets created, that is APK file gets created. So, to create an application package ready to be deployed on a Google Play Store, right click on a project, click on export, select the Android category, select the export Android application, click on next. So, here I got the indication that no error found, that means my application does not have any error and it will successfully run on a Google Play. So, here the project name is already pre-filled, click next. Then here we can enter the existing key store. So, then what is the key store? So, key store is the authentication if anyone asks you. So, it's an authentication for your application. So, if you do not have one, you can create a new key store by selecting this radio button. Give the location of your choice where you want to save the key store. So, click the browse. So, I will store my key store in a desktop. Give the file name. So, I will write the name as key store, click on save, make up the password, which should be sufficiently long. Click on next, give the alias name, so application, again password. Then validity years 20, first name, so it will be your company name or your personal name, so IITB. So what is the indication that a 25 year certificate validity is recommended? So I cannot put the 20, a 25 year certificate validity is recommended, so I will change it to 25. And now the indication has gone, and these are some optional fields. If you want to put, you can put. Click on next and select the destination for where you want to store the sign in APK. So go to the browser, and again I will save into the desktop only. So it's already prefilled, androidapp.apk. Click on save, and here I got the message that certificate expires in 25 years. That means my application has a validity up to 25 years. Click on finish, and now I will show you the two files. So these are the files, key store and my androidapp.apk. And these two files I am going to use when I will publish onto the Google Play Store. So this is the last phase of publishing an application on a Google Play Store. So before that, I will show you a different ways of publishing an application, or different ways of distributing an application. So there are three ways to distributing an app, but before you publish your application on a Google Play, we have a three methods. So as an open platform, Android offers a choices. So you can distribute your Android application to the users any way you want. So using any distribution approach or a combination of the approaches that meets your needs. So these are some alternatives for distributing an application. So first one is what? Through an application marketplace like Google Play. So Google Play is the premier marketplace for an Android application and is particularly useful if you want to distribute your application to a large global audience. However, you can distribute your application through any app marketplace you want. The second one is the through email. This is the easiest and quickest way to release your application is to send it to the users through the email. So to do this, you prepare your application for release and then attach it to the email. So here you can see this is a Gmail, and here I got the mail and with the attached file APK, that is android.apk. And when you click on this attachment, it will pop up with the two buttons, install and cancel. And when you click on install, it will automatically install it on your device. So the distributing the application through the email is convenient if you are sending your application to only few trusted users, but it needs a few protection from piracy and unauthorized distribution, because anyone can simply forward it to someone else. Now the third one is what? The through a website. Suppose if we have some website, we can also distribute the APK through that website. So if you do not want to release your application on a marketplace like Google Play, or if you do not want to send it through email, you can make up your application available for a download on your own website. So to do this, you need to provide a download link of the release ready APK, and then Android protects the user from inadvertent download and install the application from the location other than the Google Play. So you need to first set settings, then security, and then the unknown resources. So if you check this, it will allow us the installation from the other resources. So this was about the distribution of APK. Now I will show you how to, now what are the steps to publish your application. So first one, is go to the play.google.com/apps/publish. There you already have .apk file, so you have to upload it, and as well as the icons and images of your application. The third step, then you will find the listing detail where you can set the language as English, Spanish, any language depending on your country. Then the title and description. So title will be the title of your application, and the description will be the description of your application. Then what is the application type? So it can be the entertainment or related to education, business, and there are many more categories. Then set your application either to be free or priced. Now the fourth step is what? Publishing option. So in that you have to set the copy protection either to on or off. Then set the content rating to all. Set your location to all location. And in the fifth, contact information. Suppose if you want the user rating or any feedback, then you have to provide the information to the user, any website name or your email ID or phone number. And finally, check for the acknowledge and click on publish button. And then your application will upload or will publish on a Google Play. So now I think you clearly got the idea of how to publish your application, and I have explained thoroughly. So thank you.